preacher certainly knows that. And I know you've said this before. You know, we do work hard to prepare the homily, to pray over, to read the scriptures, the commentary, and so on and so forth. And then you go out in the back of the room and say, well, I really like what you said about something. You say, not here. But they were working on something in their lives. Praying on it in some sort of phrase, but thinking with the grace of the Holy Spirit, and they slowly turned off the rest of the homily and prayed everywhere they were. Because God's grace grows within us in mysterious ways. And it's extraordinary. At the end of Mass, we have a dismissal. We say, forth, glorify God by your lives. That's a mission statement. It's a mission statement for each and every one of us to become a sower of God's grace. Just as we receive God's grace from a soul, it's a seed to be spread. It's profitable. May God have our souls in grace. Today, we celebrate Father's Day. We give thanks to the Father figures in our lives. It's never complicated, but it is part of our heart, part of who we are. It's part of God's grace. I can only remember one or two tender, impactful moments of interaction with my own dad. But more importantly, more consistently, I remember that consistent love and service. Something as simple as cooking breakfast for the weekend or helping out with different things. It taught me to myself to express love without words, which is almost impossible. We have a lot of opportunities to spread God's grace and be part of that. This is why we have a parade coming up. We will try to work and do our part to recognize and support the dignity of the members of our LGBTQ+ community. The worth of each and every person as a child of God made in God's image. The wonderful thing is that God's image is so diverse. Tall, short, fat, thin, young, old, us. This week we celebrate Juneteenth, a celebration of emancipation, and we recommit ourselves to real equality, real dignity, equality in education and employment and housing and healthcare and social. Because of the presidential campaign, we have the politics of immigration come through. 25 or 30 years ago, we had a working system for immigration and asylum seekers in this country, but it has become underfunded, understaffed, and a crisis. We need to be sowers of grace to deal with it. One of our parishioners who regularly working at the meeting table decided to put down to El Paso to project in front to give direct service to the migrants. Each has to find out what each can do. We're called to sow the seed by word and deed. We do make a difference, just as the good that so many have shared with us has made a difference in our lives. The gospel says Jesus spoke with so many such parables. He spoke the word to them, as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them. He took his own disciples, he explained everything. I don't think we always feel like Jesus explained everything to us. But Paul says we walk by faith and not by light. If we know that we are accountable for how we use the gifts we have. Jesus tried in many different ways to get his message across. Some got it, some didn't.